Afternoon friends, so in the last class we have finished the chapter that is vectors. So today we start the new chapter that is integration. Today we start the most important chapter for the exam as well as for JEE. So it is integration, and the weightage of this topic, there is one mark question, two mark question, two 3 mark question, one 5 mark question and one 6 mark question. So 1 plus 3, 5, 8, 11, 16 is 21 marks. Right, so 3, 5, 8, 5, 11, 16, 5, 16, 16 is 22 marks. So we can see 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5, 8, 11, 69, 22. Right, so in here exam, we are having 1 mark question, 2 mark question, 2, 3 mark question, 1, 5 mark question and 1. 6 mark question in integration, the weightage of this topic is 22 marks. So before going to start the topic is integration, everybody should be very perfect in differentiation. The exact reverse process of differentiation is integration, right? See, in integration, first we'll see all the standard formulae. See, what is derivative of? So later in the second chapter, we have application of integration. There I am explaining what is the principal meaning of integration. So next chapter we have application of integration, where we are using this integration, so that I can explain in the next chapter. So that is application of integration. To find the area under the curve, we are going to use this concept. First we study all the concepts in integration. In the next chapter I will explain what is the use of integration. Okay, see, first we see all the standard formulae. See, if you differentiate, first point, if you differentiate y with respect to x, we are getting dy by dx. Right? So if you integrate this dy by dx, we are getting y. If you differentiate this y with respect to x, we are getting dy by dx. If you integrate this dy by dx, we are getting y. Means what? This integration and differentiation, they are exactly reverse of each other. If you differentiate y, we are getting dy by dx. If you integrate dy by dx, we are getting y. Now later I will explain. See, integration and differentiation, they are exactly reverse. So now first we will see our standard formula. See, so what is derivative of any constant is 0. So therefore actually integration of 0 is some constant a plus c. Right, so I will, where see constant of integration, that I will explain what is the meaning of constant of integration later. See, derivative of x is 1, therefore integration of 1 is x. So derivative of any constant is 0, integration of 0 is some constant a. So derivative of x is 1, so integration of 1 is x. So see, derivative of x raised to n, it is n into x raised to n minus 1. Integration of x raised to n, it is x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Okay. So then derivative of log x is 1 by x. So then what is integration of 1 by x? Integration of 1 by x is log x. So this formula is very important. Right? So derivative of constant is 0, integration of 0 is some constant a. So derivative of x is 1, integration of 1 is x. So derivative of x raised to n is n into x raised to n minus 1. Integration of x raised to n is x raised to n plus 1 by x plus 1. Derivative of log x is 1 by x, integration of 1 by x is log x. So what is derivative of 1 by x? 1 by 2. Derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Now integration of 1 by x square is minus 1 by x. Derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. What is integration of? Integration of minus 1 by x square is plus 1 by x actually. Integration of minus 1 by x square is plus 1 by x. If you take this minus on the right hand side, integration of 1 by x square is minus 1 by x. Right? So derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. Derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. C. Similarly, integration of e raised to x is also e raised to x. Is it clear, friends? Right? So, derivative of constant is 0, integration of 0 is some constant. Derivative of x is 1, integration of 1 is x. So, derivative of x raised to n, n into x raised to n minus 1. Integration of x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. Derivative of log x, 1 by x. Integration of 1 by x, log x. Derivative of 1 by x, minus 1 by x square. Integration of 1 by x square, minus 1 by x. Derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. Integration of e raised to x is also e raised to x. First write this. They have many formula. So, first write this formula. See, students, next we have C. These formula everybody should remember. C. So then what is derivative of root x? D by dx of derivative of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Similarly, integration of 1 by 2 root x is root x. Derivative of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Integration of 1 by 2 root x is root x. Then what is integration of 1 by root x? This 2 will come here. Just to cross multiply. Integration of 1 by root x is 2 root x. Is it here? Or we can write like this also. We are multiplying divide. Integrate 2 right as it is. Integration of 1 by 2 root x is root x. Is it clear? So actually integration of 1 by 2 root x is root x. And what is integration of 1 by root x? Integration of 1 by root x is 2 root x. Is it clear, friends? Derivative of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Integration of root x is integration of 1 by root x is 2 root x. Right? Similarly, derivative of a raised to x is a raised to x into log a. Integration of a raised to x is a raised to x divided by log a. So similarly, derivative of sine x. What is derivative of sine x is cos x. So integration of cos x is sine x. Derivative of sine x is cos x. Integration of cos x is sine x. Derivative of cos x is minus sine x. Integration of minus sine x is cos x. Then what is integration of sine x? Integration of sine x is minus cos x. Actually, derivative of cos x is minus sine x. Integration of minus sine x is plus cos x. Then what is integration of sine x? Minus cos x. So derivative of integration of sine tan x. Integration of tan x is sec square x. Derivative of tan x is sec square x. Then what is integration of sec square x? Integration of sec square x is tan x. Derivative of tan x is sec square x. Derivative of cosec x is minus cosec x into cot x. So integration of minus cosec x into cot x is cosec x. So if you remove this minus, is it clear, friends? Derivative of cosec x is minus cosec x into cot x. Integration of cosec x into cot x is minus cosec x. So derivative of sec x, derivative of sec x is sec x into tan x. So therefore, integration of sec x into tan x is sec x. So then derivative of cot x is minus cosec square x. Similarly, integration of minus cosec square x is cot x. So then what is integration of cosec square x? That is minus cot x. These are all important formulae everybody should remember. Without this formula, it is very difficult to understand the chapter integration. Right? So derivative of root x is 1 by root x. Integration of 1 by root x is 2 root x. Integration of derivative of a raised x is a raised x log a. Integration of a raised x is a raised x by log a. Derivative of sin x is cos x. Integration of cos x is sin x. Derivative of cos x is minus sin x. Integration of sin x. Actually, integration of minus sin x is integration of minus sin x is plus cos x. But what is integration of sin x? Integration of sin x is minus cos x. Derivative of tan x, sec square x. Integration of sec square x, that is tan x. Derivative of cosec x, minus cosec x into cot x. Integration of minus cosec x into cot x is plus cosec x. But what is integration of cosec x into cot x? That is minus cosec x. So derivative of sec x is sec x into tan x. Integration of sec x into tan x is sec x. So derivative of cot x minus cosec square x. Integration of minus cosec square x is plus cot x. Then what is integration of cosec square x? It is minus cot x. Is it clear, friends? Please go through all this formula. Once you remember this formula, easily you can solve the problems on integration chart. Write this formula fast. Still we have many ideas.
Integration of 1 by 1 plus x square is
tan inverse. Derivative of sine inverse is 1 by root of 1 minus x square. Integration of 1 by root of 1 minus x square is sine inverse. Derivative of cos inverse is minus 1 by root of 1 minus x square. Integration of minus 1 by root of 1 minus x square is cos inverse. Derivative of tan inverse is 1 by 1 plus x square. Integration of 1 by 1 plus x square, tan inverse x. Similarly, derivative of any constant into x. So that is, answer is constant. For example, derivative of 2x is 2. Derivative of 10x is 10. Derivative of minus 5x is minus 5. Derivative of ax constant into x is that constant. Derivative of 5x is 5. Derivative of 3x is 3. Derivative of 10x is 10. Similarly, integration of any constant is constant into x. For example, integration of 2, it is 2x. Derivative of 2 is 0, right? So derivative of ax is a, integration of a is ax. So derivative of 2 is 0, but integration of 2 is 2x. Integration of 10 is 10x. Integration of 5 is 5x. Integration of 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 into x. So integration of any constant is constant into x. Is it clear, students? Derivative of constant is 0, but integration of any constant is constant into x. Next, what is derivative of c? Derivative of e raised to ax. Already we know that is a into e raised to ax. So in differentiation, we are multiplying the constant, but in integration, we are dividing that constant. Integration of e raised to ax is e raised to ax divided by a. For example, integration of e raised to 3x is e raised to 3x divided by a. Integration of e raised to minus 2x is e raised to minus 2x divided by minus 2. Integration of e raised to minus 5x is e raised to minus 5x divided by minus 3. So in differentiation, we are going to multiply that constant. In differentiation, derivative of e raised to 3x is e raised to 3x into 3. But in integration, integration of e raised to 3x is e raised to 3x divided by. Is it clear, students? In integration, we are dividing that constant, but in differentiation, we are multiplying that constant. We are multiplying that constant. Right? So that one is for my first.
So if you take plus here, then minus will come here.
integration of sine is minus cos. For example, see, integration of cos 3x, integration of cos 3x is sine 3x divided by 3. That we have to divide that constant. Integration of sine 10x, integration of sine is minus cos. Minus cos 10x divided by 10. Right, so integration of sine 3x, integration of sine is minus cos 3x divided by 10. Is it clear, friends? Right? So in differentiation, we are multiplying the constant, but in integration, we are dividing that constant. Right? So in integration, we are dividing. Derivative of e raised to ex is a into e raised to ex. So, but what is integration of e raised to ex? Already told you. That is e raised to ex divided by e. In differentiation, we are multiplying a constant, but in integration, we are dividing. Similarly, derivative of. So, log of ex plus b. What is derivative of log of ex plus b? 1 by ex plus b into derivative of ex plus b, 3. Is it clear? So now that answer is a by ax plus b, correct? So derivative of log of ax plus b, what is derivative of log? 1 by x, that is 1 by ax plus b, into derivative of ax plus b. Derivative of ax plus b is a. So what is integration of 1 by ax plus b? It is integration of 1 by ax plus b is log of ax plus b divided by a. We have to divide that x coefficient. So next. So now derivative of log of a plus bx, it is 1 divided by a plus bx into b, or you can write ax plus b into b, you can write out of, now it is b divided by a plus bx. Similarly, what is integration of 1 by a plus bx? It is log of a plus bx divided by b. See, students, derivative of log is 1 by x into derivative of ax plus b is a. Derivative of log of a plus bx, 1 by a plus bx into b. What is integration of 1 by ax plus b? Log of ax plus b divided by e. So, integration of 1 by a plus bx, log of a plus bx divided by e. When we can apply log? When this x power is 1, so then we can apply log. But integration of 1 by ax square plus b is not equal to log of ax square plus b. This is wrong. When this x power is 1, then only we can take log. When we have x square, we have some other procedure that I can explain. But formula is, when this x power is 1 in the denominator, then only we are getting log. So if the power of x is not equal to 1, then we are not getting log. Is it clear? So integration of 1 by ax plus b is log of ax plus b. But integration of 1 by ax square plus b is not equal to log of ax square plus b. When the power of x is 1, in the denominator, then only we can have log, right? So that one is for me. Is it clear, friends? In the differentiation, when we have these constants, we are multiplying that constant. In integration, when we have constant, we are dividing that constant. That is the major difference. Is it clear? So that. So still we have many formulae, but right now these are the very basic formula everybody should remember. So still we have many formula in integration. So everybody should buy this formula. If you are very perfect in formulae, easily we can solve the problems in NCERT book and easily we can solve CET questions also. First and foremost thing is everybody should remember these all formulae. Still only it is 25%, still 75% formula are there in integration. Over. note down these answers. Integration of sec x is log of sec x plus tan x plus. Later I will show this. Integration of cosec x is log of cosec x minus 1. Write this formula. Integration of sec x, log of sec x plus tan x. Integration of cosec x, log of cosec x minus 1. Integration of sec x, log of sec x plus tan x, integration of cosec x, log of cosec x minus 1. If you differentiate this, we are getting sec x, we can verify. If you differentiate this, we are getting cosec x. Write this formula as integration of sec x, log of sec x plus tan x, integration of cosec x is log of cosec x minus 1. Why we are writing that plus c after integration? Already I told you, when we differentiate this y, we are getting dy by dx. When we integrate this dy by dx, we should get this same function y. So that is f of x. If you differentiate this f of x with respect to x, we are getting f dash of x. If you integrate this f dash of x with respect to x, we should get the same function what we are having here. Is it clear, friends? This is because the integration is reverse process of differentiation, and differentiation is reverse process of integration. For example, see, now you take sin x. What is derivative of sin x? What is derivative of sin x? It's cos x. If I integrate this cos x, I should get sin x. Well, these two functions should be same. Derivative of sin x is cos x. If I integrate this function, I should get the same function. So integration of cos x is sin x. Is it clear? So derivative of y with respect to x is dy by dx. Integration of dy by dx is y. Derivative of f of x is f dash of x. Integration of f dash of x is f of x. Right? So now I will explain why I am writing plus c every time after integration. See students. Now I take a function y is equal to that one you can take. Dy sin x. Now I can find dy by dx. What is dy by dx? Derivative of sin x is cos x. Now I should integrate this. So integration of dy by dx. Integration of dy by dx. D by dx and integration they are inverse. Integration of dy by dx is 1. Integration of cos x. Integration of cos x is sin x plus. We are getting same. So now I will take some other function. Y is equal to sin x plus 3. Now differentiate, that is dy by dx. What is derivative of sin x? It is cos x. Derivative of t is 0. Derivative of t is 0. That is, we are getting dy by dx is equal to, that is, cos x. Now if we integrate, integration of dy by dx is y. What is integration of cos x? It is sin x. But what is the original function? Original function is sin x plus 3. Here I am getting only sin x. So I am writing plus c to adjust this constant every time. So here there is no constant. In this case, this c value is 0. Here, in this case, what is the c value? C value. Is it clear, friends? If I integrate sin x, so that if I differentiate sin x, I will get cos x. Integration of cos x is sin x. Right? So if I differentiate sin x plus 3, this constant will eliminate. After differentiation, this constant will eliminate. When we integrate, we are missing this constant. See, derivative of sin x is cos x. Derivative of t is 0. Integration of cos x is sin x. But we are not getting this 3 here. Already I told you, after this integration, we should get back this original function. Right? So when I integrate, differentiate, we are getting sin cos x. Derivative of t is 0. After integrating this, I should get the same function. But here 3 is missing. Integration of cos x, I am getting only sin x. But what is the original function? Original function is sin x plus 3. In order to match this constant 3, so I am writing c every time. So in this case, there is no constant here, c will be 0. In this case, what is c? That c value. You can take another number. Y is equal to log x plus 5. If you differentiate, see, differentiate. What is derivative of log x? It is 1 by x. Derivative of y is 0. So that is dy by dx is 1 by x. Now if we integrate, integration of dy by dx is y, integration of 1 by x is log x. But this phi is not getting back. This phi has eliminated in the process of differentiation, that phi is not required. So in order to get back this phi, we are writing that plus c. So here, what is the c value? C value is phi. So you can find the exact value of c. I will tell how to find this c value. By using some initial conditions, we can find this c value. So that is there in the differential equation chapter, which is the third chapter in part 2. So in that chapter, I will tell you how to find the value of c, that is constant of integration. In this function, if you find that c value, you will get 0. In this function, if you find that c value, you are getting 3. In this function, if you find that c value, you are getting 5. That constant of integration we can find by using some initial condition, that is there in the chapter differential equation. Is it clear, friends, why we are writing plus c every time? After differentiation, that constant has been removed. So that constant is eliminated. So in order to get back that constant, we are writing plus c every time. Right? So based on initial conditions, we are having different values of c that we can find. So which is there in differential equation chapter, that I can explain in that chapter how to find the value of c. Is it clear, friends? What is the necessity of writing plus c every time? So very simple. If there is any constant, after differentiation, that constant will be eliminated or that constant is removed. So in order to get back that constant, because after differentiation, if I integrate the same function, I should get back the same function, right? So in order to get back that constant, I'm writing plus c every time. Already, right? So sin x plus 3, if you differentiate, we are getting cos x. Right? So if I differentiate the sin x plus 3, so we are getting derivative of sin x is cos x, derivative of 3. If I integrate this cos x, I should get back the same function here. But integration of cos x is sin x, but this 3 is missing. So in order to match that c, we are writing plus c every time. So this is the necessity of writing plus c every time after integration. After integration, in integration chapter, after integration every time you have to write plus c. This is the reason why we are writing plus c. Is it clear, friends? Now I will solve some problems based on XHDL formula. Still we have not started any problem from NCERT book. See. So what is, how we can use XHDL? What is integration of XHDL, students? Integration of XHDL, it is XHDL plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus. So just we are increasing this power by 1. For example, integration of x, what is x power is 1, just we increase that power by 1, x square divided by 2 plus. Just what is there, it is n, here it is n plus 1. So just we increase that power, 1 plus 1 is 2, integration of x square, just we increase this power by 1, that is x cube by 3 plus. What is there here, that will only come to the denominator. Similarly, integration of x power 4, just we increase that power, x power 4 plus 1 is 5 divided by 5. Integration of x raised to 10, what is the integration of x? Just increase this power by 1. 10 plus 1 is 11 by 11 plus. Similarly, what is the integration of 1 by x cube? How to find this? Here also we can use the same formula. 1 by x cube is nothing but take this x cube in the numerator. That will become x raised to minus 3 into dx. Now it is in the form of x raised to n. What is n value? N value is minus 3. That is x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. What is the formula? Integration of x raised to n, x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. What is n value? It is minus 3 plus. It is x raised to, it is minus 2 divided by minus 3. Minus 3 plus 1, it is minus 2 by minus 2. Similarly, integration of root x. How we can find integration of root x? That root x, we can write as x raised to 1 by 2. How we can write root x? Root x is nothing but x raised to 1 by 2 into dx. Now this is the form of x raised to n. What is the answer? X raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus. It is x raised to, what is n value? N value is 1 by 2. Root x is nothing but x raised to 1 by 2. So what is integration of x raised to n? It is x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. X raised to, now 2 ones are 2. 2 plus 1 is b by 2 divided by b by 2 plus. That is 2 by 3 x raised to. Is it clear, friends? So now integration of, now see, 1 divided by x raised to 5 into dx. So we do integration of 1 by x raised to 5. So take this x raised to 5 in the numerator, that will become x raised to minus 5 into dx. That x raised to 5, if you take it in the numerator, that will become x raised to minus 5. So what is integration of x raised to n? It is x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. What is n value? Integration of x raised to n is x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. What is n value? That is minus 5. So it is x raised to minus 5 plus 1 is minus 4 divided by minus 4 plus 1. Okay? So similarly, what is integration of x into root x? Now see students, what is integration of x into root x? Integration of x into root x, c. So this is x into root x is nothing but x raised to 1 by 2. Right, x into root x is x raised to 1 by 2. Now base is same, we can add the powers, which is equal to x raised to, it is 1 plus 1 by 2 into dx. Because we know what is x raised to m into x raised to n, that is x raised to m plus n. Here base is same, base is x, power here it is 1, here it is 1 by 2. When base is same, we can add the powers. 1 plus 1 by 2, that is integration of x raised to 2 1 plus 2, 2 plus 1 is equal. Is it clear, students? X into root x, right? X into root x is nothing but x raised to 1 by 2. Now, this is in the form of x raised to m into x raised to n. What is x raised to m into x raised to n? X raised to m plus n. So, now x raised to 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. Now, this is in the form of x raised to n. What is the integration of x raised to n? X raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Is it clear? So what is n value? It is 3 by 2. What is n value? It is 3 by 2. So finally, what is answer? X raised to 2 1s are 2, 2 plus 3, it is 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2 plus 3. Is it clear, students? Right? Is it clear? See, x into root x, x into root x, we can write it as x raised to 1 by 2 into dx. Now base is same, we can add the powers, 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. Integration of x raised to n plus 1 by n plus 1. What is n value? 3 by 2. So therefore, 3 by 2 plus 1, 2 1s are 2, 2 plus 3, x raised to 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2 plus 5, which is nothing but 2 by 5 will be x raised to 5 by 2. This 2 will come to the numerator, right? So therefore, 2 by 5 will be x raised to 5 by 2. So any function which is in the form of x raised to n or 1 by x raised to n, we can, if it is in the form of 1 by x raised to n, take it in the numerator like this. 1 by x cube, take it in the numerator and apply x raised to n. 1 by x raised to 5, take it in the numerator and apply x raised to n. If it is root, so it will be in the form of x raised to n. So this is all for problems based on only one formula, that is integration of x raised to n. So integration of x raised to n is x raised to n plus 1 by n. Integration of x square by 2, just we increase the power by 1. X square, x cube by 3, x power 4, x power 5 by 5, x power 10, x power 11 by 3. So 1 by x cube, take it in the numerator, apply x raised to n formula. Similarly, root x is nothing but x raised to 1 by 2. What is the integration of x raised to n? X raised to n plus 1 by n plus 2. Integration of 1 by x power 5, take it in the numerator, that is x raised to minus 5, x raised to minus 5 plus 1 by minus 5. X into root x, this root x is nothing but x raised to 1 by 2. 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. Is it clear, friends? So write all these. So in the next class, we will start problems from NCERT book. Today, go through all the formula. Just to write all the formula in one separate sheet, or just to buy all the formula. Without that formula, it is very difficult to understand integration chapter. Is it clear, friends? So write on this and write all the formula in separate sheet, and you can refer for a few days. After that, it will become perfect in formula. Is it clear? So okay, thank you.
Thank you.